So yes, there will always be challenges, but how you overcome those challenges, I think, is quite easy if you're willing to open up your mind and actually embracing it.
I'm sad to say that only in the last 2 years have I really had any personal confrontations of racism. And that only happened just before this whole COVID situation happened. And I was confronted by a man at the train station who actually abused me racially. But you know, I can't say that I've actually had that experience in the past.
There will always be challenges because no matter whenever you move to a new country, you are putting yourself in an environment where you're not comfortable. Some people see that as a challenge. I see that as kind of a new way of learning. I always look back to the history. You know, many of the people who've, especially the Chinese, who've come here in Australia back when many in the space of the 200 years, they faced probably a lot more challenges than what I would have faced, and also the current migrant faced. You know, we're talking about people who came here who was literally victimized and also have been targeted because they're Chinese or whatever. I would say that would be that's a history lesson learned.
我在国内的时候念的是英语专业，然后来到澳洲呢，就是学的是电影。 从事这个学习完了之后，我开始做一些社区的翻译。其实沉寂了蛮长一段时间，不太知道，也不太确认我自己能不能做出些什么东西。那么还是觉得电影电视是我的一个passion吧。然后在重新开始立志说要创作写东西，一直都做这方面的创作的工作。然后最近也拍了一个跟口译员题材相关的网剧，叫做《莉莉东西》，然后英文名字是 Girl Interpreted。我在
Berkshire 上面卖艺的时候，然后有一个女孩，差不多30岁这样子，然后过来跟我讲说你能不能抱一下？我说好，没问题。 然后抱了他之后，然后他说，让他就觉得，就是你的音乐给了我很多力量。然后我觉得，哇，我从来没有想过说，我拉琴这件事情会给别人带来很大的影响。然后通过那一天之后，我觉得，就是街头艺人这件事情可能不只是给大家一个 entertainment， 就是这就是一份工作，对，就是我用我的琴来讲故事。
And I would encourage anyone to come and explore Australia. If you think about living or study here, absolutely come and, you know, try it out. If you're not comfortable reaching out to, you know, someone local, reach out to the Asian community. There's so many of us here that I know would be so helpful for someone who just moved to Australia. So don't be afraid to do that, absolutely.